So after Pythagoras theorem and trigonometric ratios, we have sine rule and cosine rule in front of us. Sine rule and cosine rule, as I told you before, that we can use these two rules in order to find the missing sides and angles of a right angle triangle and a non-right angle triangle as well. But we mainly use these two rules for a non-right angle triangle. We use Pythagoras theorem and trigonometric ratios for the right angle triangle. Sine rule and cosine rule are two basic rules, which are sine rule has only sine in it, and cosine rule, as the name suggests, has only cos in it. If we have a triangle ABC and the side opposite to angle A will be written as small a, and the side opposite to angle B will be written as small b, and the side opposite to angle C will be written as small c. You can also replace these three alphabets with A, B, B, C and C, A. But this is the standard form, so we are discussing this. A, B will be written as C, and B, C will be A, and C, A or A, C will be equals to B. So we can write our sine rule as A, the length of side C, B, upon the sine of the angle opposite to it. That is A, sine A. B, upon the angle opposite to it, sine B, C upon the angle opposite to it, sine C. These three are the sides of the length. These three are the lengths of the sides, and these three are basically sine of angle A, sine of angle B, or sine of angle C. We can write this sine rule as sine A upon A, sine B upon B, and sine C upon C. It depends upon what we have to do. This formula is basically used when we have to find the missing length. So length r at the numerators, and this formula is used when we have to find the missing angle. So all the angles are in the numerator. So it is easier for us to find the value. We do not use the whole formula at once. We just pair them like this. And how do you know that which pair you will use? That will tell you, the data will tell you which pair to use. You will first look at your given data and then you will identify which two I have to use. If A, sine of A and sine of B is given to you, and you just have to find the missing length and you just have to find B, so we'll use this formula. If B, sine of, if angle B and the side opposite to it is given, and the angle C is given and you just have to find C, you will use this formula. And if sine C and C and sine A is given and you have to find the value of small a, then you will use this formula. Remember, these three formulas can be used to find the angle and are also used to find the missing lengths. It just depends upon your data. The data in sine rule, almost at least two angles should be given to you. You can't use sine rule if two angles, the value of two angles are not given to you. This is the limitation of sine rule. If two angles are given to you, then you can use sine rule. If only one angle is given to you, you can use cos rule. And if two angles of a triangle is given to you, you guys know that the sum of interior angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. So you can find the third angle very much easily. By adding them and subtracting it to 180, you can find the third angle, because the sum of interior angles of a triangle is always equals to 180 degree. So sine rule is used when at least two angles are known. When two angles are given to you, you can use sine rule. And if only one angle is given to you, you will use cosine rule. What is cosine rule basically? Cosine rule is a square is equals to b square plus c square minus 2bc cos a. You have to memorize it, and it's not that much. If you are finding out the length of side A, the angle will be cos A. If you want to find out the missing length B, then it will be cos B. If you are using A, then the sides will be BC. No A on this side. If you are using B, no B on this side. The side will be A and C. If you are using C, no C on this side. Just A square plus B square. And this AB will be with 2 as well. This BC minus 2BC. AC minus 2AC, AB minus 2BAB. And if you are finding out the A, you will using cos A. If B, then cos B. If C, and then cos C. These three formulas are for the missing lengths, and these three formulas are for the angles. You just have to make cos A alone. You will shift it on that side, and you will shift A square on this side, and your formula will be like this: cos A, cos B, and cos C. If you want to find out the angle, you will use these three formulas. If you want to find out the length, you will use these formulas. These two are basically same. You just change the subject. So cosine rule is used when only one angle is given to you and you have to find the side which is opposite to that angle. This is the limitation of cosine rule. The angle is given to you and you have to find the side opposite to that angle. You will use cosine rule. And if two angles and one side opposite to those two angles are given to you, you can find the other side by using sine rule. If one angle is given to you, you will be going for cosine rule. If two angles are given to you, you will be going for sine rule.